Hi everybody, Scott Card here with another quick video on Proteus. Today's question comes to us from a viewer who asked if it's possible to create traces with different sizes and how to separate them, perhaps to one layer or another. The first thing that we have here is you can see that I've set up, I've already laid out a circuit board, and nothing fancy. This is just a very generic bridge rectifier with a capacitor, an indicator LED, and a couple inputs and outputs. This is completely fictitious, and I've placed it onto a circuit board. So specifically, if we run the auto router or use the auto trace selection, we're going to find that there are a few things that we can do. So the first one is that we can determine whether things are going to happen on the top copper or the bottom copper by going into the net classes. And so if I say that my signals, I only want them on the bottom copper, for example, I can do this. So I can say bottom copper and bottom copper. When we run the auto trace, we're going to see that it does a reasonable job, but all the traces are the same size. But we can choose whether it goes on the top or the bottom. And perhaps this is a good moment to point out a couple of other neat features. One is if I choose track mode and I select all of my items, I can delete or select them all to be deleted. The other way is that I can actually choose to bottom layer. Okay, so here we go. We're able to choose just the traces on the bottom layer. Okay, perfect. So let's say that we want our signal traces one size and our power traces another. A quick way to do this would be to actually assign these as power traces. And the generic way to do this would be to actually create a power pin and a ground pin. Okay, so again, this is the easy way, maybe not the right way for everything, but here we go. This time when we check out our design rule manager, we can see that there under net classes, there are signal and power. And we can define what the actual power traces are going to be in this case. We could crank them way up to say T25, which is 25 thousandths of an inch thick. We can choose the different via styles, and we can choose whether or not we're going to neck it down if it's tight. And we can also choose again whether it's on top or bottom copper. Right now I'll just let it run on both, and here we go. We'll begin routing, and as you can see, we do have the thicker traces here, and they're labeled as ground now and as BCC VDD, but the other traces are not. And so this is again not ideal, and so let's take a look at how to take this a step further. Okay. And the way to do this, the proper way to do this, is to actually start to assign some net classes. Okay. So what I can do is I can add a wire label here. And what I want to do is not just put a layer, but I want to define a net class. And in this case, we can specify this as a power, because this is already something that exists. And we can say okay. Okay, so here now we have something called class equals power, and I can do the same here. I can put another net class and call this one power as well, and that's going to be okay. And so what I can do is I can even add another wire label here and actually call this one DC plus, and I can do the same here. So we'll right click and place a wire label and call this one DC minus. And now auto router again, we're going to see those power traces, they do have labels now, that you can see that it is called DC minus and DC plus, and that it's updated the thickness. Okay. And this time I'm not going to delete it because I want to show you another neat trick. So this time I'm going to go in and I'm going to right click and I'm going to put in a wire label and a net class. But this time I want to create a new net class. And this one I'm going to call AC. And maybe we do something special with AC. So for example, maybe we want it even thicker. Maybe we want 50 thousandths of an inch. We'll leave the default next style. Now let's crank it up. Why not? We'll take it all the way to TV 30. Why not? And we can determine in this case, I only want it on the bottom copper. Maybe there's something special about this. And so we've set this net class AC to bottom copper, heavy traces. And we'll do the same here. Okay, so again, place a wire label. And because we've made this, we don't have to choose anything special. We just pick it and you'll notice that it all defaults. Now, when we go back to our layout, we can see that under the net class rules, everything's going to be there. We'll do net class rules. Perfect. So there's our AC. Everything's set perfectly. And now I'm going to rerun my auto router. So here we go. And notice everything's on the bottom and the way we want. Okay. So perfect, very handy, very useful. I think the other thing that I would like to point out to you is if I lay in traces manually. Okay, so this is fine and dandy, but if you do want to create a special trace that's going to deviate from your defaults, you absolutely can. What you want to do is turn off the auto trace selection, choose the trace that you want. In this case, we'll go with a T100 because that's crazy. Okay, and we'll drop it in. Okay, like so, and the real takeaway here, the reason why you may want to do this is for unique traces. And you'll notice that when you run the auto trace, one thing that won't happen is it won't tear up any of those traces that you've already selected. All right. So there we go. Multiple traces, different sizes, different classes, and you can take this a step further if you want and actually start to modify some of the clearances around those traces as well by going into the design rule manager and start to play around with different rule names. And I'll save that for another video. If you like this video, let me know. If you'd like to see a video on how to set up design rules, let me know down in the comments below. If you do like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If not, I'd love to hear why not. Your constructive criticism helps me improve. And as always, thanks for watching and have yourself a great day. All right. Bye now.